Be careful to blame your prostate when it comes to chronic pain. Many times the prostate has nothing to do with it. So chronic non-bacterial prostatitis, chronic pelvic pain, you can name it what you want, but stop thinking prostate and start thinking pelvic floor. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board certified urologist and sexologist. For many men, there's an easy solution to their agony. It's called low intensity shockwave therapy, or ESWT. ESWT is easy to perform. It's all physics, no medication involved, and the best part of it, no side effects. There have been scientific reports about this effect for over 10 years, but the medical community so far hasn't embraced that concept. Don't ask me why. Patients with chronic pelvic pain are difficult to treat. It's frustrating for both the patient and the doctor, and it is very time-consuming and exhausting. In a busy practice with a tight schedule, a patient with chronic pelvic pain can throw their entire day into disarray. Shockwave therapy is time-consuming and ties up resources. In other words, patients with chronic pelvic pain are bad business. However, those who work with shockwaves on a daily basis sooner or later comprehend that it can be the magic wand in achieving success in patients no one was able to help. I came across it by accident during the pandemic 4 years ago. An old friend of mine called me up and wanted to see me because he had been diagnosed with chronic prostatitis. When he came to my office, he was in very bad shape. He had constant pain in his perineal area. Certain body positions would worsen the pain quite dramatically. Driving to my office for several hours was torture to him. By that time, I had already heard that my ESWT device could also be used for pelvic pain. So I treated him, which was a painful experience for him. I had to adjust the power of the machine quite substantially. Each session, I was able to increase it a little. After 2 weeks, we started seeing effects. After 6 weeks, he was pain-free. This was 4 years ago, and he still has no recurrent problems. After him, there were suddenly lots of other patients with this kind of problem. The first 10 of them were all cured. At that time, I realized, this is too easy. It can't work in every patient. And I was right about that. With time, I learned that I still achieved high cure rates, but some patients were not helped. Maybe I treated the wrong area. Maybe I didn't reach sufficient penetration depth of the shockwaves. Maybe the reason for the problem was something else. Because the method works by treating trigger points in an overactive pelvic floor. The pelvic floor consists of several layers of muscle which are attached to the pelvis. The pelvic floor plays an important role in the center of the body. It coordinates movement, defecation, and sexual activity. It even connects to breathing. This complicated system of muscles is very susceptible to failure. If you think I'm only talking about men here, you are mistaken. Pelvic floor issues are a reality for both men and women. As you may know, women don't have a prostate, but they have the exact same symptoms. So what now? There is no prostate which could be blamed. Medicine found a solution for that. If there is no prostate, we just blame it on the bladder. Don't get me wrong, there are bladder problems in women, no doubt about that. I am simplifying things to make my point. The pelvic floor easily becomes tight and overactive. This results in pain in the perineal area, urinary urgency. It can have an impact upon urinary flow, resulting in a weaker stream, postmicturition dribble, erectile problems, a burning sensation after orgasm, testicular pain, daily fluctuations in symptoms, typically little or no problems during the night and in the morning, with the complaints then building up towards the evening. What does science have to say? The current guidelines of the European Association of Urology conclude that ESWT is probably effective. The level of evidence is 1B, which is very high. But for some reason, they don't explicitly recommend it. The body of scientific evidence is meager. They included one study that is over 10 years old, which didn't show long-term effects. which may then conclude that the results are not stable long-term. I don't agree with that. In my experience, the results are surprisingly durable. However, the problem is the underlying cause. In most cases, this cause can't be identified. It can be psychogenic, it can be a problem of the hips, or something related to altered movement patterns, or sitting on a chair at a desk all day long, etc., etc. Therefore, I believe multimodal treatment is optimal for addressing potential underlying causes. A specialized physiotherapy can be helpful, as well as something like yoga or meditation. Chronic pelvic pain still is a therapeutic challenge, as it can have many underlying causes. Therefore, this video is not medical advice. Individual problems have to be solved individually in the office and not in the comment section on YouTube. If you are suffering from pelvic pain, go see your local doctor. However, if you want an educational online consultation with me, I will link my calendar in the description. Curious about shockwaves and how they work? This video explains it all. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.